Barrow-in-Furness is the principal town of the Furness Peninsula, divided from the rest of Lancashire by Morecambe Bay and a corner of Westmorland. It is of comparative modern development and has a population of over 64,000 people. To the south and west of the civic centre lie the docks, shipyard, engineering, iron and steelworks, whilst to the north and east are the residential quarters of the town. This is a view of Paxton Street from the Town Hall Tower. Over the industrial area to the west lies Walney Island, which not only shelters the docks, but whose beaches provide the town with amenities much enjoyed by both residents and visitors alike. The town has a good shopping centre, and of a Saturday, Dalton Road is crowded with shoppers, all hopeful of acquiring the day's bargain. There is a fine covered market, which always attracts large crowds, irrespective of the weather. Barrow has several fine buildings, of which the Town Hall, this is a view taken from the west, the new police station, which was designed by Barrow architects, and the public library are but a few. Several hotels of repute cater for the needs of visitors. This is the Duke of Edinburgh, the Victoria Park Hotel, and the White House, situated near to the public park. Its schools are amongst the finest in the country, and Barrow should be proud of its achievements in education, both academic and architectural. Finer housing estates have yet to be seen, for it is the council's firm belief that good houses make good tenants. This is a view of the New Barn South Estate, looking down Bridgegate Avenue. Recreation is catered for in the public parks, open beaches, public swimming baths, both open air and covered, and many private clubs and associations. It can be seen how well the people of Barrow use their public amenities. The park caters for bowls, tennis, and boating. The greatest need for Barrow is light industry, where unemployed labour can be absorbed. In this field, Listers and Gilbert and Kellett's have set a good example. In concluding this very short film, what better example can be given of genuine thought for the retired workers of the town than a glimpse of two existing homes for the aged, namely Abbey House and Rock Lee. In the very near future, George Bosterfield House will be added to bring peace and comfort to those who have reached the evening of their lives. It is perhaps remiss of me to omit the town's most ancient building, but this monument to the past is a subject worthy of a film to itself.